That morning, Kathryn contacts Dr. Susan Kolb, a local plastic surgeon.
She called and said that she was having symptoms of fibromyalgia, symptoms of neurological problems.
She immediately knew what I was talking about and then even brought up a symptom that I hadn't mentioned, which was the pain down my arm.
The problems that Kathryn had were very typical of other patients having severe problems with their breast implants.
To find out if Kathryn's implants could have been making her ill, Dr. Kolb must physically inspect them. 72 hours later, Kathryn is taken into surgery.
We put her to sleep on the table, and then we make an incision just above the crease of the breast. And we go to the scar tissue around the implant. Then we opened it up and took the implant out.
I remember waking up to Dr. Kolb standing by my side saying, Kathryn, you're not gonna believe this. Both of your implants were black.
I couldn't believe it. I was disgusted. And then I understood. I understood how they could have been making her sick. And the fact that I did not believe Kathryn, that I doubted her, that I thought this was in her head, it felt horrible.
When I saw Kathryn's implant, I knew that the implant was making her extremely ill. It was black with particles floating in it.
Kathryn's implants are made up of a silicone sac that should be filled with a clear saline fluid. Whatever is floating inside the dark liquid has been poisoning Kathryn for months.
The implant was sent to an expert that was able to show the presence of micro-organisms. The major fungus found inside her implants was Aspergillus niger.
The spores of Aspergillus niger have somehow penetrated Kathryn's implants. Here they float through the liquid saline filling, feeding on blood proteins and reproducing. As the colonies grow, they release toxins that poison Kathryn's body.
The fungus Aspergillus niger is relatively common and often found in bathrooms. It's the black mold that grows in the sealant around a tub, but can also infect people. If a person breathes in a large quantity of spores, the spores can establish a colony in their airways. Once established, the mold can cause breathing difficulties and lung disease.